the reality of everything Jesus sees, everything he has done. We need the precious Holy Spirit like never before. And the Holy Spirit, I'm so grateful that he's better at showing himself than us knowing where to find him. Hallelujah. I am so grateful for the precious Holy Spirit. I cannot put it in words. Lift up your hands. Say, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for all you are, everything you have done, are doing, and will do through the reality of the cross. Have your way, Father. We pray in Jesus' name that we decrease because you increase. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. I feel like telling you what I see. I saw, I don't have one to show you, but I saw a big plug. You know, like here, when they vacuum, they have an extension cord here when people vacuum so that they can go all the way in more places, right? And the Lord is really releasing forth an extension cord because he wants us to stay plugged in. He wants us to stay plugged in. He's the source of life. He's the source of everything we need. Everything in our lives always come to disconnect us, to get us to plug into the wrong thing. And I praise God that the Holy Spirit knows how to throw an extension cord when we need one. When I think of fasting and when I think of the update that he's doing, really the way to get an update is to plug in. You can't even get an update if you stay on a battery, even with a phone, you need to plug it in. That there is something powerful about even when you think of a corporate fast, of however, and you know here when we say fast, it can be and it has to be whatever is difficult for your flesh to give up. For some people it's difficult to give up TV, for some others it's not. Some people, it's difficult to stop playing games, but not you because you're adults. Drink some water. This. I know some people, when they're playing games or watch TV, they don't eat. So, hallelujah. But all these things that the Holy Spirit will lead each one individually to do, and it could also be to just give up social media. It could also be to give up the negative words of your mouth. Really, when you fast any kind of food, whatever is difficult for you, for me, it's French bread. Other people might never eat French bread. So if you tell them fast French bread, well. So each of us have to be led by the Spirit. And really, the difference between and what's outdated and what's an update, the update has to do with what the Holy Spirit wants to download in you to prepare us for the upcoming upheaval, for any upcoming shaking that you go through, every trial you go through in your life. The Holy Spirit is so awesome that I've seen him over and over and over again prepare you ahead of time so you can walk through whatever you need to walk through. An update by the Holy Spirit is when he download upon you, when you plugged in. If you're not plugged in, you can't get this update. You have to plug in. And really, truly, If you're a child of God, you are plugged into the source. So you have, by faith, you have to remain plugged in. And often, in order to do this, you have to unplug the wrong thing. When you get an update from the Holy Spirit from glory to glory, you know what he does? He downloads new information. He brings the word alive to you in ways that you never had it before. That's why when you read the announcement about the fast, it includes seeking him first in your day and reading as much of the word as you can read. That to allow you even above and beyond what you usually do. The same way we eat a whole lot in the natural, we need to feed our spirit. Man, we need to be able to go to him, the source, not to get information from the world, because some of the things will bring you fear, not faith. Not get information and download that somebody else has downloaded. Thou shalt not trust the internet. Thou shalt go to the source and get plugged in. Father is looking for people to download things that have a pioneer spirit, instructions, different things that he wants you to hear and to know for such a time as this. Because when you know him straight from the source, no one, nothing can take you away from what your father tells you. You need to know your daddy for yourself. Hallelujah. It's a time and it's a season to unplug from the wrong thing, to plug in onto God, to go to him first, so that he can even unplug you in every area that you need unplugging, for the rivers of life to flow through mightily through you, for you to be a well everywhere that you are. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit, he brings new information. You read a scripture that you thought you knew, and he'll just bring it alive. And when he does that in your life, you have to know that it's because he wants you to see how by his spirit he brings life upon that word, so you can be a doer of that word like never before. We don't fast as a religious exercise. There's plenty of other religion who fast, but they don't plug in to the only source of life. I said the only. Did I say the only? The only source of life. The Lord says the letter kills, but the spirit gives life. And it doesn't mean the word. Some people have said the word is the letter. No. It's this outdated and update has to do with the carnal versus the spiritual, the flesh versus the spirit, so that we can become unplugged, so we can be aligned, to hear clearly, to have surety in our steps. Because if we're not plugged in, then the enemy will bring doubt and second guessing, and he'll remove the confidence, not in yourself, but in God, that you need for any upcoming upheaval. I know upheaval is supposed to be spelled U-P-H-E-A-V-A-L. It's a geological term, but I've always called it the upheaval, E-V-I-L. Because the enemy is always trying, and in this season more than ever before, but he has no power like our God has power. So we plug into the power source. The Holy Spirit not only bring you new information, so when you fast, you have to read the word, feed yourself. Not just I know. Sometimes, you know, because we wait to be led by the Holy Spirit, we might not open the word because we wait for him to lead us what to read. But I know the Lord, he leads us as we drive. He leads us as we drive. And what I notice with having a Bible reading program, and not reading your Bible while the TV is on. Ooh, I need some water this morning. I remember one day I was reading the word, and the worship music was playing, and it was a song that had words, and I felt the Lord said, turn it off. I said, oh yes, Lord. I said, it's worship music. He said, yes, but the way your human brain works, you'll try to multitask. I said, oh yeah, you're right. I have the tendency to do that. You'll have the tendency to read your word while you're worshiping. He said, and I remember that was years, years ago, and I started, when I read the word, I just have instrumental. The background. It's so quiet in here. I felt it this morning when I walked in. I said, oh Lord, so quiet. He said, it's my presence. Do you feel his presence? Just so thick in this place. So thick. It's just beautiful. So anyway, where was I, Deacon Leroy? I forget. I have no clue what I'm talking. Read the word so you can hear him read you. When the Holy Spirit brings an update, what it means really in this season is when you have an update in anything technical or in anything in your life, it's what's put in you at the same time as you receive the download, as you really get to upload in yourself his word. There's also a removal that he brings, and a correcting, a correction of anything that needs to be corrected. I love that. I love that the Spirit of God, he supersedes who you are. He doesn't tell you, hey, you have to remove that. He'll download the new. He'll bring you an update, and he'll do it when you're right here. I'm going to use this as the upload, the update. I like this. Some people on New Year's Eve, they were coming to me asking me, how do you know if it's time to let go of something? Because the outdated is not what's old. We're not talking about what's old or new. We're talking about what's worse for another season, as you walk in a new one. And at times you could be standing at a door knocking, but it's a season that you need to move out of that place of waiting because God has something else. How do you know when there's something that's no longer for this season? This is how I know. If I don't know, I don't make any decision, I take this. Don't be scared. It's not heavy. I know you're looking at me like, what is she going to do? I saw myself lifting the thing. You take what you're not sure. You bring it to the foot of the cross. And you allow God to put his thoughts, his word on everything that you don't know. But you can do it if you're not plugged in. You can do it if you're not plugged in. What I find as a child of God is when you update, when you stay plugged in with him, he'll remove things without even you knowing. You would look for things, wondering, well, I wanted to do that last month. How come I don't want to do it anymore? That's how you know you're led by the Holy Spirit. If you stay plugged in at every season of your life and not moved by prideful ways where, God, I thought you wanted me to do that in 1960. No, no, no. Father, the scripture that the Lord gave us for the new year is he must increase. But we decrease, and the scripture I'm hearing that's connected to staying plugged in is John 15:7 or 8, somewhere in the neighborhood. I am the vine. You are the branches. Gonna read it. He who abides in me and I in him, he shall bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. Well, I just tried it, I guess. But I want to give you the scripture reference. It's John 15, verse 5. It says, I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples. Whoa. When you stay plugged in, when you abide in him, whatever you nurture about, even things that you don't know, shall be done for you. If you focus on his word, on worship, and of course to abide in him cannot be done without prayer. Prayer is the most important thing because it's communication with him. And prayer sometimes doesn't have to be with words. Sometimes you just have to abide and stay in his presence. You just have to unplug the world around. You just have to be so careful not to plug into the wrong thing, because it's difficult, as much as the enemy will try to unplug you from the world, from the word. The enemy will do that in such a way that you won't even see yourself unplugged. But when you plug into the wrong thing, you start seeing it impact you in ways that you didn't know could impact you. If you plug into the wrong food, it's not just your body that will experience the damage of the wrong food. I don't know if you ate a lot during the holidays, but if you feed your flesh too much, you can't pray because you fall asleep. Because we spirit, soul, and body. We spirit, soul, and body. No, spirit man, we already plugged in. But we need to unplug the wrong things in order to remain plugged in. We need to abide in him and his word abide in us. There is no greater joy for Father when he see you seeking him, not just in your words, but in action. When you say, Father, I need to hear from you. I'm going to let go of this thing in the natural just so that I can be unplugged and plugged into you. Father is looking for those who meet him in the secret place. He's looking for those who worship him in spirit and in truth. There is no greater joy for a father than to see his son trying to be a doer of the word, not in a religious manner, but in a way that really says with your action, apart from you, I can do nothing. I need to know. I need to know your voice. I need to experience your presence. I need to hear you. I need to speak to you. I need to receive fresh manna from you. I cannot do anything without you. And if that means that I'm going to stay plugged in ways that I'm going to have to shut things out, even if I have to unplug and tell people around me, listen, you're not going to be able to reach me in this upcoming 21 days because I'm only going to be on the phone when I have to. I'm only going to send a text if I have to. I need to unplug from this. I need to unplug from the TV. If you're married, to tell the people around you that you do what you led to do, but I need to unplug. Hallelujah. I need to unplug. I need to seek. They used in the book of Acts, you could see that the people of God used to stay up all night praying, seeking Father. Yeah. Father, who do you want to do this? Father, what do you want me to do about that? Father, even in the Old Testament, you see how David was inquiring of the Lord. He needed to hear because he was in a battle. He was in a battle. There's enough things that come against us that's unexpected, than us to be soldiers that don't have our weapons sharpened. We need to have our weapons sharpened. When you're in the midst of a battle, you don't have time to go back. You can look for your gun and it's unloaded. You don't have time to call somebody else and say, can I use your weapon? You're standing right there and you need to be able to walk in the authority that you have in God and know what's been downloaded onto you. I think of an update of a Father giving us by the Spirit of God everything that we need in order to be able to be in a way that we can be used. If there's no update, we can't be used effectively. Need to have an update. You need to be plugged in. I don't know if it ever happens to you, but the moment you decide to unplug from some things, the phone will ring, people will come at you, you will find yourself in unexpected warfare that you won't even be able to do what you thought you were gonna do, but the Holy Spirit will come upon you and cause you to press through. To press through, and even if one day you have a low day in whatever, you say, Father, I'm not gonna drink. I don't know what soda do people, what Dr. Pepper tastes nasty. I'm not gonna drink any Dr. Pepper for 21 days. What I found, the greatest fast is not always things that you have to stop doing, but it's things that you have to start doing. And this way you stop not doing it. Add the good stuff. Instead of saying, I'm not gonna drink Dr. Pepper, start telling us, I'm gonna drink water. I'm gonna drink water. I'm going to exercise. I'm going to eat salad. I'm going to eat a healthy breakfast. Because if you stop all the wrong things and you don't add the new thing, it's the same thing with the word of life. If you want the mind of Christ and if we want to be able to have his thoughts on the matter, We can't go by what somebody else's opinion is about the word. We even have to be careful of mindset that we might have ourselves. We need to be able to be so sharp in this season. And what I love is there's nothing that you can do on your own. But he said, apart from me, you can do nothing. So the Lord says, come on to me. Go to me first. Go to me first. Go to me the first thing you do when you wake up. Go to me before you make a decision. Go to me before you too quickly move in the flesh. Go to me before you say yes to what your flesh wants. Go to me before you go to other people in a computer. Go to me. Come on to me. All ye who labor and are heavy laden, come unto me, abide in me, and I in you. If my words abide in you, if you're careful to unplug for the thief that come to steal, kill, and destroy, there's some things that I will do unto you in this season, because you will be aligned for the best that I have for you. I desire for you to have the best, but I've given you your free will for you to abide, for you to make the decision. Yes, Lord, I'm coming to you. Apart from you, I can do nothing. My desire is that you increase. My desire is that your presence, your power, your provision, your protection, all that you are, my God, that I will seek you first and your righteousness. I seek your kingdom above all. And all these other things shall be added unto me. Father, give me your heart to pursue you, to seek after you with my whole heart, 100%. Give me your fire to seek after those things that come from you. Let me lay hold of the altar. Let me start praying and be in my prayer closet and let the whole world stay unplugged. Cover my ears that I won't even be able to hear the noises of my family. Cover my ears that I won't even be able to hear my own thoughts. Help my relationship with you be the number one relationship in this season, that you may increase, that I decrease. Father, I plug in for the update. Update me, Lord. Have your way. I surrender all. I present myself a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable. Oh, Father, I don't want to be conformed to the world. Oh, Father, well, what is it that you have for me? And if all that I'm hearing in this season, and Father, he doesn't say do this and do that. He just says, come to me. But for me, you can do nothing. And just rest in my best that I already have done. So don't be concerned about what you can do, cannot do, and I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that. I remember years ago, you know how sometimes you make list of what you want to do and you think you want to do, and I felt that the Lord says, make another list. I said, what list? He said, make a list of everything that I have done. I made a list. It was a long list. The more I wrote what he has done, the more I was writing. You saved me. You set me free. You gave me a sound mind. You gave me a spirit of power. You gave me your love, your peace, your joy, your gentleness. You pulled me out of the pit. You pulled me out of the miry clay. My mind was gone and you put it back together. When I didn't know how I was going to walk in provision, my Father, you provided. When I had no one to protect me, you protected me. My Father, I cannot even measure all the things that you have done. And then he said, now rest. Hallelujah. Rest in that. Said every time you make a list of what you want to do, align it with what I have done. Every time you're not sure, wait until I show you. I will work through you. I will work with you. I will lead you to co-labor with me. And many times you make a step, you don't know what's the next step, but it doesn't matter as long as you know that he walks with you. It's not about the step that you make. You make mistakes, but Father, he always loves to teach you. And what does he teach you? His ways. Because when I think of what's outdated, it's not, you know, oh, that's old. Everything in God is always fresh. It's nothing old about God. Actually, there's some things, some foundational things that sometimes people, even when it pertains to the gospel, they try to come up with something new and get people unplugged from the foundation of the truth. If we could just walk in what he has done, he said, greater works shall you do. If we could have all be on the same unity of one goal, which is that he may increase. For his truth, for the gospel to go everywhere we go. That's our vision, that's our goal, individually and as a corporate body, isn't it? The enemy always comes with things to just pull you away, especially if you're a parent or a grandparent. Because the temptation will be to get plugged in their stuff. Plugged in. People that are going through things in trying to help them, and leave your place. When what God wants to do is he wants them to plug in. You're not the extension cord. They need to be plugged in to him directly, and the Lord will show you, don't do that for this person. Don't plug in that situation. Stay in prayer. And watch me cause something to happen, that they'll be plugged in to my truth. I am the way, the truth, and the life. It's nothing like the life of a child of God. And listen, many of us are busy. So what I'm showing you is a hard thing. It doesn't mean that you can, you know, stop going to work tomorrow and call in your boss. I went to church, taking 21 days off. God told me to plug into him and unplug from you. We're great, so will your paycheck. Your paycheck will also unplug from your bank account. No, actually what I found is that the greatest time is to be able to do it first thing in the morning so that all day long you stay plugged in the midst of your job, in the midst of the battle, in the midst of people walking in the flesh around you, for you to have that quality time to plug in. Father is looking for a willing heart. He's not this Father, you know, give me 20, give me 40. Suffer for 21 days. I want you to have just bread and water. I don't want you to have any TV, no phone, no computer. I want you to sweat and suffer. No, that's religion. We're talking about a step-by-step walk in abiding in his presence everywhere we go and removing distractions and hindrances. He will tell you the fast that he has for you. Nobody else. And he'll do it one day at a time, one moment at a time, one meal at a time. And you know, for me, what I love is to be able to live that way. Not just 21 days of the year, but meal by meal, day by day. Father, that I may abide. Lord, you the vine, I'm the branches. Don't pay attention to the other branches, please. Don't try to cut them off. Wonder how what kind of branch they are. Don't go get your clippers. Don't get any strings to help them. Don't hold them. The vine. You're not the vine. Hallelujah. Just you are the branch, so abide. Don't look for the fruit. You will bear. The word much is literally above and beyond what you can even see. That means even after you walk out of a time with your family, your friends, your job, there will be fruits following you. A word that you release by the Spirit of prayer will bear much fruit. Father is watching over his word to perfect it. There's something wonderful about living a fasted life. But sometimes the Holy Spirit will tell you to do something for 3 days just to unplug really quick. And the only way you can unplug is if you first plug in. I love updates, because if you don't update your technical equipment, it starts freezing up, start getting stuck. Nothing flows. But the Holy Spirit, he wants you to go with his flow in this season. If you could see in the Spirit everything that he has for us, I get excited, because to me, the story that we are in is the most glorious story ever told. To me, whatever God has for us is the best. He just wants us to align with his best. He doesn't want us to stay with chicken feed when he calls us to be eagles. He's not calling us to suffer. He partook of suffering, that even if you go through sufferings in the natural, he will uphold you. His update comes with uplift, upload, upflow. I don't know if that's a real word, but I think it sounds good. Upflow, is that an English word? It should be. Let's check with Webster. It's a word? Oh, hallelujah! Upflow. It's time for the upflow. The update for the upcoming upheaval. Woo! It's time for us to just remain unplugged to the flesh and plugging to Him. Are you with me? You know, every year we do something like this corporately, but people sometimes they don't realize the power of agreement. One of the things that we have is for us, wherever you are, whether it's at 6 a.m., 9 a.m., noon, 3, 6, to come in agreement as the Holy Spirit remind you, set your phone. And let's pray the Our Father in one accord wherever we are. Let's come together in one army, one body, one goal. Hallelujah. Let's receive glorious upload for the upflow. Hallelujah. Are you with me? I feel in the Spirit the Lord is pulling this extension cord I've seen, and He's pulling it at you. It's almost like no matter how much you think you need to stretch, He stretches you more. He stretches more towards you. The moment that you draw nigh unto God in your heart, He draws nigh unto you. He draws nigh unto you. It's easy, us human beings, to think, well, I know I need to plug in, but I can use the battery. Sometimes if you have a laptop or something, you know, I remember one day I'm thinking, well, how come this computer doesn't work? And I check everywhere and did all this thing and did searches and looked for the book and, you know, and then suddenly I heard, it's not plugged in. You ran off all the battery. The batteries for me is what men can come up with. It's better to stay plugged in all the time. Amen? It's easy to let the cares of the world and things just take you away from that. I'm excited because starting tomorrow for 21 days, I pray that what we'll do will take us to a change in habits. That Father will just speak to you in such a way that you will remain abiding as much as you can. Because what if you prepare for 21 days and something happened on the 22nd day, you'll be ready. But what if something happened in 90 days? Does that mean we're only powerful on January 25th? That's why we have to take care of our temple. And I pray soon we'll have like a support group for those things. Because you know, we need to pay attention to our temple, to the thoughts and all this. Let's help one another. Let's encourage one another. Let's say bye to the colonel, Mr. Kentucky. Sounded good, Kentucky. Let's say bye to Mr. Olays. Let's say bye to all the things that really are destroying our body. Are you with me? Are you excited about the corporate fast starting tomorrow? I think today, between whatever we do, well, we have to prepare, we have to go to the store, set yourself up for success. Hear from God. Just plug in. Stand to your feet and tell Father, yes, Father, I will plug in. I will stay unplugged. Thank you for the update. Let your word abide in me. I abide in you. And you in me, Lord. You the vine. I am the branch. I will bear much fruit as I abide, as I plug in. Apart from you, I can do nothing. But because I'm a part of you, all things are possible. Have your way, we pray. One accord in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.